All right, stick with me here. What if Senate Republicans traded Herschel Walker to House Republicans for like a package of 10 candidates? It's a novel idea. The news in late August that former NFL star Herschel Walker is going to run for the Senate from Georgia is an absolute nightmare for Republicans hoping to retake the majority next November. And what's even worse, they probably can't stop him from winning the Republican nomination. Walker starts the race with high name identification, primarily derived from his years of football stardom, and the vocal support of former President Donald Trump for his candidacy. Quote, "He would be unstoppable, just like he was when he played for the Georgia Bulldogs and in the NFL," Trump said in March of a Walker candidacy, adding, "He is also a great person. Run, Herschel, run. Run, Forrest, run." Walker, as the Republican nominee against freshman Senator Raphael Warnock, is a minefield, though, for Republican strategists who do view, rightly, Warnock as one of the most vulnerable Democrats up for re-election next November. Why? Why ask why? Just kidding. Here's why. Number one, Walker hasn't lived in Georgia for a very long time. So Walker registered to vote in the Peach State exactly 1 week before he announced his Senate bid. He had lived in Texas for the past several decades. Moving back to the state to run for office opens Walker up to charges that he's only back in the state to run for office. And he has no easy answer for that. Number two, he's been accused of threatening behavior. Walker has been open about his diagnosis of dissociative identity disorder and the struggles it has caused him, including writing a book about his life experiences. But a recent Associated Press report went through Walker's business and divorce records and reveals troubling and previously unreported behavior by the former NFL star. Quote, "The documents detail accusations that Walker repeatedly threatened his ex-wife, exaggerated claims of financial success, and alarmed business associates with unpredictable behavior," end quote. Now, worth noting here, Walker did not respond to the AP's request for comment on their report. Number three, he's never been a candidate for anything before. So a Senate race is a tough place to make a maiden campaign. And that goes double when you're talking about what will likely be one of the most closely watched and most expensive Senate races in the country. Walker will now be under a very bright light. And if past his prologue, he could struggle at times under that sort of scrutiny. Now, of course, Warnock had never run for any office prior to his successful Senate bid in 2020. So it's doable. It's just far from easy. Now, it's worth noting here, campaigns always take on a life of their own. They're often very unpredictable. But what's clear from all the stuff I talked about above is that Walker brings significant baggage, carrying my bags, to the contest and has hard questions to answer about his past residency and his past behavior. That reality has already led some Republican strategists close to Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell to speak out publicly about their concerns of nominating Walker. Quote, "This is about as comprehensive a takedown as I've ever read," tweeted Josh Holmes, a longtime McConnell advisor, in July in reference to that AP story, adding, "My lord." McConnell himself has yet to speak out publicly against Walker, but according to sources cited by CNN, he's made his reservations very clear privately. Wrote CNN's Manu Raju, Alex Rogers, and Mike Warren, quote, "Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell has suggested to allies that former Georgia Senators David Perdue and Kelly Loeffler should take another look at running again, according to three sources familiar with the matter, after their narrow losses in January flipped the Senate to Democratic control," end quote. The problem for McConnell is that, as I noted above, Walker has a very high likelihood of being the party's nominee, given his celebrity and the likely strong backing he'll have from the former president of these United States. There's also a relatively weak field of other Republicans in the race at the moment. State Agricultural Commissioner Gary Black is probably the best known of the Republicans not named Herschel Walker, but Gary Black isn't exactly a household name. Plus, Walker and Trump standing behind him could well keep better known Republicans like Loeffler and Perdue from entering a race they're not sure they can win. Speaking of that, given the current power dynamic in the Republican Party, it's not at all clear to me, at least, that a McConnell-backed candidate like Loeffler or Perdue could overcome a Trump-backed candidate like Walker, even with the various issues I documented surrounding him. Which would then mean that in one of the Republicans' best pickup opportunities in the country, The party would put forward a candidate who is an opposition researcher's dream, not to mention someone who has never run for any office prior to 2022. If that scenario does come to pass, it has implications well beyond the Georgia state lines. So Republicans need to net just a single seat to retake control of the Senate in 2023. And Georgia, with a narrow victory margin for both Warnock and President Joe Biden in 2020, is at the top or near the top of the list of potential pickups. Lose Georgia, though, and Republicans need to find a pickup elsewhere, in places like Arizona, where Senator Mark Kelly looks pretty strong, or New Hampshire, where all Republican hopes lie with the potential candidacy of Governor Chris Sununu. In short, Senate Republicans are not in a place where they can simply write off one of their best pickup chances without feeling the impact in other places around the country. And while no one should say conclusively that Herschel Walker would lose to Raphael Warnock, it's quite clear that the former running back would have major challenges if he wound up as the Republican nominee. The worst thing for McConnell and his fellow establishment Republicans, they know all of this. They just might not be able to stop it. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.